Drew Gordonas, papildęs Vilniaus Lietuvos ryto komandą, prieš keliaudamas į Lietuvą turėjo panaršyti internete tam, kad suprastų, į kokią šalį vyksta. Dabar amerikietis teigia esantis patenkintas dabartinė situacija.
I gotta be honest, I didn't know much about Lithuania. I had to look up if it was, you know, what type of weather it was and what city I was going to be in. So that was fun, because I got to do it with my family, so everybody became more educated as soon as I signed the contract on Lithuania. Being here, it's nice. I really enjoy the city so far, the weather and everything like that. And everybody's been very polite, very kind to me.
Aukštaūgis yra ragavęs ir Eurolygos, ir NBA duonos. Stipriausioje Europos lygoje jis sužaidė 10 mačų, o NBA 9. Amerikietis norėtų vėl grįžti į aukščiausią lygį, bet dabar telkiasi į savo darbą Lietuvos ryte.
Everybody's dream, I feel like, is to play at the highest level of basketball that's possible, whether that's Euroleague or the NBA. It really doesn't matter at this point. You know, I'm playing for this team this year, and whatever comes next, we'll get to that when it comes. I really am not trying to focus on anything farther than, you know, the present moment and being the best team that we can be this year. You know, obviously, if we play well, good things will happen next year.
Drew Gordonas LKL pirmenybėse sutinka ir gerai pažįstamą veidą – žalgirietį Leo Westermaną. Šie vyrukai kartu žaidė Belgrado Partizan komandoje.
We also played against each other last year in France when he was playing for Limoges. Leo's become a very good friend of mine. You know, I'm happy to see that he's doing well, and I'm happy to be able to play against him again this year. You know, it's always fun to see people that you've played with progress throughout their careers.
Serbijos ekipą tuomet treniravo Duškovo Joševičius, kuris pagarsėjęs kaip itin griežtas treneris. Gordonas išvelgė šiek tiek panašumų tarp serbo ir Lietuvos ryto vairininko Tomo Pačėso.
Dule was a very strict coach and he wanted the very best for his players, and he was very passionate about how he was going to maximize the potential out of his players. So, you know, I think coach is also very passionate about his players and wants the best for his players. So there's moments, you know, where he might be frustrated with us. It's just getting to learn the coach and learn the players. I mean, there's some similarities, but ultimately, everybody's different. And, you know, everybody has a different view of basketball, a different type of philosophy. And you just kind of got to learn and adapt with it.
Duškovo Joševičius yra asmenybė, apie kurią galima šnekėti valandų valandas. Tai treneris, kuris nekalba angliškai, todėl žaidėjai privalėjo išmokti serbiškus krepšinio terminus. Maža to, strategas savo auklėtinius kontroliuodavo taip, lyg šie būtų jo vaikai.
I had to learn a little bit of Serbian, mostly basketball terms. We had a translator, but his English was a little shaky, so half the time I would get in trouble because he would, you know, translate something wrong and I would do the wrong thing, so I ended up learning enough basketball terms in Serbian to where I could get by. He put a curfew in at 12 o'clock, which is understandable when you're playing season, but, you know, if you have a free day or, you know, you're with family or friends and you stay out late after a game, you know, whether you go to a restaurant with your family, Andule didn't really like the fact that you were out past 12, and he would ask for the apartment keys of everybody on the team. I didn't give him my apartment keys. You know, a couple players were able to keep their keys just to make sure that Dule didn't show up at 12 o'clock at night banging on your door to see if you were alive. Other than that, you know, he was very strict in practice. He didn't let anybody speak. And if you did speak, you'd be punished. And I have to run stadium stairs of, you know, the whole stadium. It was a very stressful situation to be in, especially being the only American. However, you did gain a lot of knowledge and you learned to be patient and you learned, you know, to really be aware of your situations and your surroundings. So, you know, there's always a positive that comes from, you know, something like that.
Gordonas su komandos draugais nusiteikė šį sezoną patriukšmauti LKL, kadangi Lietuvos rytas nori nutraukti Žalgirio viešpatavimo lygoje. Žalgiriečiai laimėjo 6 titulus iš eilės.
We come to play basketball, we come to win. So every year that I play basketball, I intend to win, and that's not going to change regardless of what level I'm at. So, yeah, we're going to get it.
Gordonas laisvalaikį leidžia itin turiningai. Amerikietis dar studijuoja, daug bendrauja su kitapus Atlanto esančia šeima bei medituoja.
My free time is usually talking to my family. I like to speak to my son a lot. I'm in school right now, receiving my master's in psychology, so that takes up a lot of time. Other than that, I like to read. I practice, you know, meditation and trying to strengthen your mind and everything like that. I don't really have too much free time between family, school, and basketball. If I do have time, it's reading. You have to be present while you're on the court, otherwise, you know, you get into your own head and you get into a funk and, you know, you don't play well. Once you practice mindfulness and being present and just being able to forget, you know, what happened negatively on the court or positively and just play, you get into a very good rhythm of just being able to be yourself and be able to forget the bads and the goods and just, you know, continue to play.
Drew Gordono brolis Aaronas rungtyniauja NBA, kur gino Orlando Magic garbę. Lietuvos ryto atstovas dėl laiko skirtumo negali stebėti visų mačių tiesiogiai, bet ryte žiūri įrašus. Aaronas taip pat stebi brolio žaidimą LKL pirmenybėse ir Europos taurėje.
Most of the time I record the games and I watch them in the morning, but if it's a big game, then I'll try to watch it live and talk to him after the game about it, about how he felt and what he did right, what he did wrong you know, just kind of talk to him about it. But, you know, with the time difference, it's very difficult to watch, you know, basketball games live because you're up at 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock in the morning. And then we watch each other's games. So we're always able to talk about what we have been doing, you know, well and what we haven't been doing and what we should do and what steps to take in doing so. And I think that really keeps us sharp throughout the year because in the back of our minds, we're playing for ourselves, but also at the same time, we're playing to, you know, talk about it later with your, you know, with your family, with your, you know, in my case, my brother and my sister, you know, they both watch my games as well. It's really cool to be able to do that.
Broliai 10 mėnesių per metus praleidžia skirtinguose pasaulio kraštuose, bet vasarą susitinka ir leidžia laiką kartu. Smagiausias jų užsiėmimas – žaidimas vienas prieš vieną.
Oh, all the time. It's our favorite thing to do. We push each other to get better every day. Since we don't get an opportunity to play each other during the year, summertime is when we really get to have fun and get better together and play together and play against each other. You know, it's really something special to be able to play against, you know, somebody else who's going to push you to get better. So during the summertime, we're together all the time. My sister's there to help settle, you know, any arguments or any disputes that come up with basketball. But yeah, we love playing against each other. It's awesome.
Ne tik broliai Lavrinovičiai, bet ir Gordonai turi svajonę kartu žaisdami baigti karjerą. Drew teigia, kad kelis kart teko su broliu rungtyniauti draugiškose mačiuose. Tai buvo nepamirštama patirtis.
We would love to play together at some point in time. We actually played together for the first time ever in our careers this summer, just in a pro-am game. It was fun because you wanted to play the game, but at the same time you wanted to just sit and watch, you know, your sibling play the game as well. You know, I think that definitely gave us more motivation to one day be able to play on the same team and play with each other for any amount of time. Like and share.